Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I am Surbhi Goel and legal intern at LexClick. Today I am going to give you a brief on the case Tips Industries versus Wing Hilsen. So let's get started. So first of all, I can tell you what was the issue in the case, whether there exists a statutory licensing scheme under the Copyright Act to online streaming service. So first of all, I would tell you the background story of the case, how the case had started. So the dispute centers around section 31D of the Copyright Act 1957, which provides for statutory licensing scheme as whereby any broadcasting organization desirous of communicating to the public any sound recording can obtain a statutory license to do so, provided they pay royalty rates to the copyright owners or at rates fixed by the Intellectual Property Law Board. So now we'll talk about the facts of the case. So Tips Industry Limited, it was plaintiff, is an Indian music label that exercises copyright over a significant music repository that in 2016 granted Wing Music Limited, that is who is the defendant, license to access the music repository. All the expiry of the said license, both the parties attempted to regulate the licensing condition but failed to do so, and hence Wing took refuge by invoking section 31D of the Copyright Act. Tips challenged the Wing invocation of section 31D and provoked Wing pursuant to section 14 clause 1 sub clause e for breach of their exclusive rights of sound recording. The Bombay High Court judgmented that after hearing the contention of both the parties, the High Court came to a conclusion finding Wing to be guilty of direct infringement on two counts. First, to offer the copyright work under section 14 clause 1 sub clause e, and second, which allowed the users to download and listen to the plaintiff's work offline, and second, under section 14 clause 1 sub clause e, third, for communicating the plaintiff's work to the users via their stream service. So in addition to the Bombay High Court sought this opportunity to clear on out their air regarding the ambiguity that existed with report to online streaming services for failing within the scope of section 31D. Under section 31D, the Copyright Act, downloaded or purchased of the copyright work is not covered. Wing Music permitted the users to download and store copyrighted music for unlimited future use, which instituted to be a sale and not communication made to public, which constitutes as a broadcast for the purpose of section 31D, and hence there exists no claim for a statutory license for the use of such copyright work by Wing Music. The application of section 31D of the Copyright Act does not include internet broadcasting. The case of defendant was based primarily on the presumption that section 31D covered internet streaming services under radio broadcasting as described in a 2016 DPIIT office circular, given that radio broadcasting included internet broadcasting under section 31D. So the court had an opposing view, in which resulted in the rejection of the interpretation put forth by the defendant. The court found section 31D to be exception to copyright, which ought to only strictly interpreted. Upon careful examination of the statutory scheme of 31D and the rules accompanying it, it becomes apparent that statutory licensing was intended to only cover radio and television broadcasting and not internet broadcasting. After examining the history stated with section 31D, the court derived that despite the global existence of internet streaming services, when the section was inserted through an Amendment Act of 2012, legislation, even though being aware of it, omitted to include internet streaming services from the ambit of section 31D. In addition to that, the memorandum presented by the defendant does not contain any additional weightage of their claim, as the memorandum only act as guidelines and lack of statutory authority, and therefore has no influence to the extent of their claim. The judgment was passed in the favor of the plaintiff, and the court held that the plaintiff was entitled to interim injunction. Having regard to the reality that they had made a prima facie case, would suffer in impeccable burn, impeccable harm in the way of lost revenue. So that's all for today. I hope you like the video. Do subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.